The penetration, no matter how slight, of the vagina or anus with any body part or object, or oral penetration by a sex organ of another person without the consent of the victim.
A complex set of beliefs that encourages a person's sexual aggression and supports violence against the same or opposite gender.
Any form of unwanted sexual behavior that is imposed on someone.
So it was my second year in college, and it was the end of the semester. And one of my friends wasn't going to be coming back the next semester, so for the first time in a very long time, I went out to a party. And I drank a lot and met a guy at the party that my friends thought was really cute because he was on the tennis team and he was an athlete and he was just super awesome. So we were all hanging out, and I didn't really realize that that's where it would end up going, that we all went back into, I have a suite style room, or I had one, and two of my roommates were there, so we were all hanging out. But you know, it got to a point where I blacked out and woke up to the assault, and as soon as that happened, you know, he just called me names and then just left. And it took me a really long time after that to realize that putting a label on what that happened, that's what it was. Because of the way that society views rape and rape culture, to me, that's not what happened. And it took me it was probably 6 months, almost a year, made it like really click in my mind like that I was raped.
Kept asking me, like, what were you wearing? Like, what were you drinking? Like, how much did you have to drink? Did you pregame?
He kind of just lectured us about how we shouldn't go out in short skirts and we shouldn't drink because, I mean, that's our fault.
Did you say no? How many times did you say no? How did you say it? Okay, what were you wearing?
There was no response. There was no response for 7 months.
I thought that if I told them, like, they would take action. But the only action they took was against me.
After I was sexually assaulted, I said I should just drop out until everything blows over. Out of school.
I went back into her office and I asked her what happened, and she looked me right in the eye and told me that she forgot.
The school's response always seemed like they were more concerned about him and his needs.
She said, you don't know what he's going through right now, neither do I. He could be really having a hard time.
They also told me, despite the fact that I had a written admission of guilt from him, that I didn't have enough evidence, and that in fact what I had presented to them could only prove that he loved me.
Our fifth story out front, shocking allegations of rape. Two high school football players in Steubenville, Ohio, have been arrested and charged with raping a 16-year-old girl after images and stories of the alleged assault began circulating on the web.
In the Texas town of Cleveland, cops there say an 11-year-old girl was gang raped by 18 men and boys. One of the suspects is reportedly just 14 years old. The others are in their 20s.
Well, dozens of protesters rallied near the BYU campus today demanding changes to the school's honor code.
Now, they want the university to do a better job of protecting victims of sexual assault.
I think society views rape as an epidemic that they don't quite know how to deal with. So it's either dealt with, sometimes it's dealt with appropriately and the victims get help and the perpetrators have consequences, but sometimes it's not. It's dealt with completely inappropriately. I think I've read a lot of articles regarding how it's handled on college campuses and some of the things that when rape is reported, it's like the victim gets punished and the perpetrators kind of get a slap on the wrist. And then sometimes it's just swept under the rug and nobody wants to talk about it. So if it is reported, then it might get reported to the wrong parties and nothing happens.
Society views rape on the outside with disgust and with how could this happen, but I think that's just a surface response. I think once you get past the surface of, oh, that's so sad, I can't believe that happened, I don't think society is moved very much to do anything about it. It seems like it's just kept quiet. If we keep it quiet and pretend like it doesn't exist and we don't have to deal with it, I think it's a lot more widespread than people want to admit to.
Now, is rape solely limited to the act itself, or is there more to it? Like verbal, is there such thing as verbal rape?
That's a good question, because I've actually never thought about that. But I
like
think to an
extent, like
I think to an extent, yeah, because I mean, it's not exactly the same of, you know, you're saying no, but I think in the act of, if someone, if a guy were to come up to me and try to engage in sex with me and I said no, but he started slut shaming me for it, I think that's definitely what it would be, even if he didn't. The physical act of it didn't happen, I still feel like that's just as traumatic. Like, even it could even be on the same level, because verbal is a lot of the time just as bad. I never thought about that. That's a good point.
I can think of a time, not at this job, but in a previous job, where a girl was complaining about her boyfriend, and it was the assistant principal told the girl, well, you shouldn't wear that perfume, you're just driving that boy crazy. And then thinking about dress code with girls, and oh, well, you know, you can't have your cleavage and your breasts hanging out because it's just gonna drive the male students nuts. It's just like, what?
I think that technology and the widespread use of technology and the ease of information on electronic devices has made acceptance of rape more common, because it's depersonalized the act. I can find porn on my cell phone wherever I am. Whether I'm by myself, whether I'm sitting in class, whether I'm sitting in church, wherever I am, I've got access to it. And because it's a two-dimensional image, it's not personal. And so any type of personal accountability is easy to erase, because I can change the screen and it's gone. And I don't have to be held accountable for that. So I think that makes its acceptance easier. I can do it at my will, at my convenience. And a lot of that comes back to at my will, at my convenience. It's all feeding me and what I feel like my needs are. And if I can go to my phone or my computer and I can access sexual acts. It takes any type of relationship, personal human contact out of it. It's just an act. And so it depersonalizes it. Makes it easier to accept because I don't know the person. I don't have to, in that instance, I don't have to see them at school. I don't have to sit in class with them. I think it makes it easier to accept and thus kind of perpetuates the problem.
Rape me. Rape me, my friend. Rape me. Rape me again. I'm the only one. I'm the only one. I'm the only one. I'm the only one.
Everybody get up.
Tell me it gets better in time. You say I'll pull myself together, pull it together, you'll be fine. Tell me what the hell do you know, what do you know? Tell me how the hell could you know? Hold your head up and be strong. 'Cause when you fall, you gotta get up. You gotta get up and move on. Tell me how the hell could you talk? How can you talk? 'Cause until you walk where I walk, it's just no talk.
Yeah.
to you, you don't know how I feel. How I feel.